Welcome to the morning call. We're always glad to have you. Now, Ivory Coast initiated a post-election reshuffle that has seen the appointment of former Prime Minister Daniel Kablan Duncan as vice president just a day after President Alassane Ouattara fired the heads of its armed forces and the police force after a brief army mutiny that stoked security fears in the country. Now, on Monday, former rebel leader Guillaume Soro who served as the Prime Minister for 5 years until 2012, was also re-elected as President of the National Assembly. Now, the country has amended its constitution, which was a brainchild of the incumbent President Alassane Ouattara, to introduce the post of a vice president. Now, while they scraped off the stipulation of that both parents of the person running for presidency in the country should have been born in the country. Now, that other story is what we're looking at today on the morning call.
Ivory Coast has experienced a week of political drama, but it is particularly on the question of the demands of the mutineers that the authorities are expected to turn. After the promises, the new government team led by Amadou Gon Coulibaly are going to have to take actions on the military insurgents. I recall that when the mutiny was over, Guillaume Soro, former leader of the rebels, and the new president of the National Assembly said on Twitter he will be a candidate. A statement that has thrown disorder on a possible political game behind the scenes on the part of Guillaume Soro. We will speak on these changes in the Ivory Coast with Maurice Maunon, a political analyst who speaks from Cotonou in Benin. Bonjour. Hello, Manon. Kablan Duncan was appointed vice president by President Alassane Ouattara. We will not say that it's not a surprise, isn't it? No, not at all. It's not a surprise because it's an open secret. We knew very well that who was not until his appointment prime minister would be at that post because the pair Ouattara and Bedi wonderfully work together. So it's a fall of Bedi, of the PDCI, who was appointed as vice president. So this is not a surprise at all at this point.
Monsieur Mahonon, quel sera véritablement le
rôle? What will his role really be? Will it change compared to that of the Prime Minister?
To
the fact he is going to expect, the Constitution provides that in the event of vacancy of power, the Vice President takes over the interim when it has foreseen until the adoption of the new Constitution, be it the President of the National Assembly. So, I do not see his room for maneuver, except perhaps to say to Bedi that he too is there and participates in the management of power, since on two occasions you know very well that he has given his support to Ouattara. What we can say already and what, when 2020 approaches after Ouattara, it will be too early to tell, but it's there, it's true, he has been the head of government, prime minister and all the rest. Now, it is at the head of the vice presidency. I see that he is going to manage the interim. In case of a power vacuum, it's him who will take the reins of the country. That's what is essential.
Dr. Mahonon, certains évoquent un risque de conflit.
Are there any risks of conflict between the vice president and the president of the National Assembly?
Est-ce quelque chose qu'il faut craindre, selon vous?
Yes, you mention a crucial problem, that is to say that after Ouattara, the war of succession. It must be said that Guillaume Soro has ambitions. Remember that it is thanks to him, whether we like it or not, that Ouattara was able to regain power, as Soro was a former leader of the rebellion. Even with the aid of French troops, it's Soro's rebels who truly fought. So logically, Guillaume Soro expects that after Ouattara, it's going to be him. But on the other side, there's also Bedi. Bedi believes that although there is RHDP that is there, and RDR will return the favor, so there will be this war of succession, which will indeed take place. Do not forget also Hamed Bakayoko, who is in the government, who resigned. He was the interior minister of state. It's true, Guillaume Soro, he was re-elected as the head of parliament. But he has ambitions since he does not want to stop at this level here. So, how will it happen? Ambitions, Guillaume Soro. Second, ambitions of the camp of Bedi. There's also Ahmed Bakayoko. So you see, like it or not, the war of succession will take place. The last question. This appointment comes a few days after the mutiny. President Ouattara, who is dismissing the heads of security forces. Is this likely to cause any further tensions in the country?
Cela ne risque-t-il pas d'attiser les tensions davantage?
Yes, it is true. One can say because, you know, Ouattara is your developer. He is an economist, and the whole country rests on the security plan, on the men of Guillaume Soro, who controls the security regime of the country. Do not forget that Somalia Bakayoko, the chief of staff who had been there since 2010, is a close friend of Guillaume Soro. He was there as the head of the rebellion. So his dismissal, it's true, it's going to cause problems. It will cause a certain grinding of teeth. Not only that, at the level of Guillaume Soro, who now embodies the political wing of the ex-rebellion, also he is now seen deprived of the interim, since in the event of the vacancy of power, it is in him, in principle, who should ensure the interim, but it is now the vice president. So it was found that this isolation on the side of Guillaume Soro, it is true the tension that reigned over the weekend at the level of the army, the grinding of teeth, at the level of the military is still to be taken seriously.